Yeah, should I be fun of Ben's?
He came up to me about 2 hours ago and asked me if I needed
it. No, we've done it before. We sat
it was online, but he said okay. What's the war update, Richard?
They're moving
troops, but they haven't crossed yet.
Army units are now moving into positions at the border, battle ready. The feeling here, war may be only hours away.
Calling them facts and not assertions, U.S. Secretary of State Colin Powell today presented what he says is evidence that Iraq is hiding weapons of mass destruction.
Simply stated, there is no doubt that Saddam Hussein now has weapons of mass destruction.
We know they have weapons of mass destruction. We know they have active programs. There isn't any debate about it.
The danger is clear. Using chemical, biological, or one day nuclear weapons obtained with the help of Iraq, the terrorists could fulfill their stated ambitions. Saddam Hussein and his sons must leave Iraq within 48 hours.
How's it looking? You sure it's not too much?
Okay, let's walk. We gotta go. Can I? Someone take a baby? Martie, we gotta hit the stage.
Behind the growing buildup to war, there's also a growing anti-war movement.
This may have been the biggest political rally in UK history. Perhaps as many as 1 million people converged on the center of London to march and denounce American plans for war.
Show, it was awesome. It was definitely mission accomplished. Audience loved it. It looked great. You know, one down, 99 to go.
If you want to feel some good old-fashioned American pride, look no further than the uproar over the Dixie Chicks.
And how they could say I'm ashamed that the president's from Texas? Come on, man. It's crazy.
The comment was quoted by London newspaper The Guardian. In a matter of days, the London story was picked up by the Associated Press and printed in newspapers all over the United States.
Personally, I hope you don't play their music again for quite a while. I think it was very disrespectful.
The people who got it all started was a right-wing group called the Free Republic.
An extreme right-wing group, for their own political reasons, are attempting to manipulate the American media, and the American media is falling for it.
The Free Republic is very well organized. There's definitely a Free Republic hit list with all of the radio stations they're trying to affect, and they are totally focused, and girls are going to get whacked.
Good morning, 61 Country.
They should send Natalie over to Iraq, strap her to a bomb, and just drop her over Baghdad.
I think people are going to say, oh, my God, what happened to them?
But this is a traitor.
It's not what we say about ourselves. It's what people have imposed on us.
It's what you've been bringing.
I'm sorry. I don't like that is going to be so common and on the cover that my concern is the average person isn't going to get it. They're going to be horrified when they see that.
It's not ridiculous to call you opinionated. It's not ridiculous to call you brave. Like, we've got to show how cruel...
It's not ridiculous to call you a big mouth.
Yeah.
No, true. This is a brilliant artistic shot. But just to see Dixie sluts? Jesus Christ.
What?
You need something to counterbalance it. Proud American. Yes, they've been branded, but I think you're giving too much credit to the American public. They're not that smart.
I don't think the average person's going to get any of it.
Then we're fucked if that's the case. I'm not going to go there. This is about fixing it.
Well, that racy magazine cover on the stands today pretty much sums up some of the names the Dixie Chicks are being called in America these days. Traitors, the Dixie Sluts, anti-American. All because of one split-second comment aimed at President Bush right before the war with Iraq.
We've analyzed the way that Diane Sawyer and Chris Woolman, what they've done in previous interviews, and we'll give you some examples. It's likely to start with a real hard punch.
It will.
You know, what you said and why you said it. You know, you don't rehearse what you say in between songs. And sometimes it doesn't come out the way that you intended.
I'm not saying I support their commander-in-chief, but I'll say I support the troops.
That's fine. But try not to be judgmental of the president. I'll tell you why. He's got sky-high approval. The war couldn't be going better. By the time this interview airs, he's likely to be at the highest point. Remember, this is 2 weeks out. The looting will be done. The rebuilding of Iraq will be started. Saddam Hussein will most likely be dead or found out. I'm just telling you, 2 weeks from now, it's going to be even a more positive situation.
So are we all going to be friends again now? We're going to have to deal with some more redneck bullshit. But I think it's at a point where you cannot go back and put yourself in the crosshairs.
Controversy from the country music world has officially landed tonight.
The Dixie Chicks launched the U.S. leg of their Top of the World tour in Greenville, South Carolina.
In my opinion, they're ignorant and they don't know what the hell they're talking about.
If you support the Dixie Chicks, you're supporting communism, you're supporting traitors.
We're tired of the anti-American voices. We're tired of the anti-war voices.
Tickets for the Dixie Chicks concert went on sale months ago.
We did buy the tickets before they said
before they said that.
We couldn't get our money back, so that's why we're here.
But these South Carolina fans had no idea that the show they were paying to see would end up becoming much more than a concert.
I think we in South Carolina ought to say goodbye to the Dixie Chicks, and anybody that thinks about going to that concert ought to be ready to run away from it.
God bless GW!
When Natalie Maines made her comments on the eve of war, most of us recognized that was reprehensible.
It hurt our men fighting overseas who think their cause is just.
Is this a matter of free speech or bad manners?
Their opinion is so ignorant.
They don't know what they're talking about.
I think they are the ditzy twits. These are the dumbest bimbos, with due respect, I have seen.
These are callow, foolish women who deserve to be slapped around.
Absolutely.